Welcome to the Blue Cafe. We offer stories of infidelity, betrayal, and redemption. Please like and subscribe. Cheers. Now, on to today's story. My wife has left me for another man and I was directed here to start the process. D-Day the 22nd of November 2020. Needs support. Edit, spaced out the wall of text to make this easier for you all to read. My wife and I have known each other since November of 2013 and started dating immediately. At the time of typing this, I am 28 and she's 24. We met when she was 17 and I was 21. 1 year in, it got kind of rocky, but we put it back together and stuck with it. We got married on May 16th of 2016. We had our baby boy 2 years ago. Just 8 days ago she told me she was seeing another man and that it was physical. She had been seeing him for 3 weeks at that point. I asked her if she thought I should leave and if I should take our son with me. She nodded, so I just went into the other room and went to bed. Just in shock. Stared at the ceiling the entire next day in between taking care of our son. The next day I threw what I could in my car and left. I want to clarify that I have a terrible drinking problem and it has consumed me. And now that it has ruined my life, I can't let it ruin my son's life. I'll be going to meetings immediately. We've been happy together all these years, made sacrifices for one another and have enjoyed each other. We lived in a city for 3 years after we got married as she was advancing her career. I was managing a retail store and making really good money. She was managing a restaurant and she was making really good money, but we never saved. We've always been terrible with our spending. On Valentine's Day 2017, we tried for a baby and got pregnant on the first try. Our debts were piling up and we had no health insurance. I quit my managing job so I could get a different job and qualify for insurance for her. You never know what can happen during a pregnancy, you know. We decided she should keep hers since she loved her job and is very passionate about it. I got another job and got insurance. That November we welcomed our son into the world on her due date, happy and healthy. The birth was natural and I held her hand through the entire process and watched my son enter this world and even cut the cord. We were so happy and so in love. Once the insurance paid out, I quit that job because it was awful and went back to the same company I was working for. Our debts continued piling up and we wound up with a Chapter 13 bankruptcy. We were surviving though. We just lived our lives for a year and a half after that and loved each other and raised our son. She begged me to move to another city for another job offer with the same company and a substantial pay raise. I told her I didn't want to give up what we had there. But she continued pushing and pushing, and 3 months later I finally said duck it and gave in and told her we could move once again and start over in the new city. I gave up everything I loved about what I was doing there, and our home that we both loved. We had so much room there and a fenced yard for our son. We moved 5 months ago and I just wound up working for her for simplicity's sake, since we were having such a hard time finding a good reliable daycare. There were days where we just worked opposite shifts just to make it work. I felt less of a man and fell into a deep depression, became cold and distant to her, and eventually we only had sex once a few weeks. I stopped taking the time to look her in the eyes, hugging her, kissing her, touching her. We became almost like roommates with a kid. We never talked about it though. She ignored me too. But I know she could see the sadness in my eyes. But she just seemed so happy with what she was doing, and I couldn't just walk away from that or tell her we needed to go somewhere else. Our apartment was abysmally small. Like tiny. We had nowhere to enjoy each other's company like we used to, nowhere for our son just to play and run and laugh. So cramped. I should have done something, gone to a counselor. Tried to find a job I loved, but I just rotted there. Drowning myself in the bottle every day. I did all the housework, the laundry, dishes, meals and taking care of our son. I was a drone just grinding through the days. She said she felt dead inside when she told me. My D-Day. She felt nothing and just had to go and feel again, feel anything. I died a little inside that day. I completely shut her out and walked away. It took me a couple of days to wake up, but I fought for her. Offer forgiveness. Offered to try to find religion with her as I'm an atheist and she's a Lutheran. Told her I'd do anything to keep her in my life, to get help for my drinking as I should have years ago. I just wish she would have given me an ultimatum before having an affair. She's already walked away though. My heart and soul are so broke right now and I'm having a hard time holding it together and I just want to drink so ducking bad, but I can't, I have to do this for my son. I've got a job, a place to live, and I've got my son. I told her I could forgive her and we could rebuild our lives together, I could give up the bottle. Focus on us. I've made so many mistakes. I gave her the same ultimatum she should have given to me a month ago, 2 days ago, and she chose him. I've been asleep for so long and I woke up this week. It's been hell. I can't stop throwing up. I've been having random panic attacks and breakdowns. I was thinking about editing all the screenshots, removing names and places and just sharing them with you all. In those messages I tried to win her back. She even had the gall to post on Facebook that she was in a relationship after I changed mine to separate. I'm over here reaching out to her and trying so hard and she's already moved on. It's like she's not the same person anymore. I sent her my closing statement from our relationship today. Going forward we will only talk about money and our son until the divorce. She's going to continue to pay on the bankruptcy and assist me financially as if we default on the Tory structure it would make life hard for all of us. Including our son. I'm going to share my closing statement now. Me, one more thing. I'm sorry I fell into such a dark place once we moved to underscore. I just wasn't happy there. I was severely depressed. I didn't focus on your needs, physical or emotional. I became even more consumed in the bottle than I ever have. I hid those feelings from you because I wanted to give you the world. I gave up the happiness of having a real home and a real job in underscore. I did that for you. I should have gone to counseling. We both should have, especially after your sister's passing. I wasn't there for you through that. I lost my passion to truly live and live through you. I cannot change the things I've done or the choices I've made, but I'm truly happy you've found a spark of joy in your life and that will keep me going. Along with the joy I find through being with our son every day. I've even already considered attempting to find another woman to love, but I can't do that. It won't be love, it will be empty, won't help anything, and it's wrong and it's not fair to our son. I've hung all of our pictures here to remind me of the love we had when we truly loved each other, and I'll keep moving forward to make sure our son is loved, happy and healthy. I'm going to find a counselor soon and just talk to someone. We both lost a lot of who we were when we moved to underscore. We became shells of ourselves and we let it take over everything. I'm sorry too that I didn't focus on your needs, your feelings and your happiness. We both were living under a shadow and it ruined us. I really hope you do go and find someone to talk to, and I hope you really do stay away from alcohol. Our son is everything. I miss him so much, you have no idea. I'm so glad that he has you. I know he's in the best hands possible. Me, but I also want you to never forget there is no justifying the choices you made either. And you can hate me for that, and that's okay too. I want you to always remember that you gave up on us and your son. We did make a vow and you broke that vow. I'm dropping it now. Have a good life. That last part of the post, the last paragraph, 5 sentences, is all that needs to be said. Hold on to that. She gave up on you and your son. She chose someone she'd been with for only 3 weeks. She killed her marriage. Whatever problems you had, you didn't seek an answer outside the marriage, she did, and therefore its failure is entirely on her shoulders. Now put down the bottle, fix yourself, and take care of your son. Go completely no contact, as she seems uninterested in keeping in contact with her child. Talk to the meanest shark of a lawyer you can find and hit her with divorce papers. Make this as real to her as it is to you. Make her face the consequences of her actions. But most of all, brother, take care of yourself and your little boy. Frith. We cannot afford a divorce. Or lawyers. Right now she's willing to continue taking full responsibility of the bankruptcy so I can focus on taking care of our son. He's a very happy little boy and developing well. We still have 21 months left and the payments are quite substantial. She makes good money though and has already agreed to help me get a better vehicle since I gave her the good car so she can continue working. I just don't want to piss her off right now. Otherwise she might not help me. Though when the time comes I have saved all the messages over the past week and if she tries to take him from me it will be blatantly obvious she just wanted to leave us behind and start a new life. She will have to pay you alimony and child support, call legal aid you can get advice for free. Right now she's agreed to give me $400 per month for childcare expenses. I'm going to save all of it because I won't need it. I will also be saving up cash from my own job and being as frugal as I possibly can be while still making sure my son has everything he needs. I want to save up enough for a lawyer to make sure she can't ever take him from me. Legal aid is a good place to start. They are attorneys who will help you for free. You need to get a binding separation and custody agreement in place as soon as possible. Wanted to share it with you all again. A lot has happened since my last post. Update. Well, it's been 5 months since everything happened and I can finally say I'm back to my old self. My drinking at this point is almost non-existent. I landed a job as an IT technician back in January and work Monday through Friday 8 to 5, perfect for daycare while being a full-time dad. So happy to finally leave my retail career behind. I did lose it for a while there in December. Having my whole world turned upside down. The anxiety and constant feeling of dread. I drowned myself in liquor. I almost stopped eating entirely, and lost 40 pounds. Sleeping only for a few hours a day. I'm 5 feet 11 inches, I was 180 and dipped all the way down to 140, currently at 155 eating normally again. It really hit the fan about a month ago. My wife and the AP broke up and got back together numerous times through the months but last month I got a random phone call from the AP as he found my number in her phone. He was going on about how she was lying to him about still talking to me. Obviously we still talk, we have a child together. He called me to tell me that he was done with her and that she's pregnant. He asked me if it was mine. I was taken back by that. It's not, she finally tried to reconcile with me. I turned her away. For the first time in years I feel like I can breathe and make my own decisions. It was my wake-up call to finally get the ball rolling and hire a lawyer. They got back together a few days after that too. The whole situation is just obscene to me. She's only reached out to see our son twice in this entire time frame so I shouldn't have any issues getting primary custody. Finally filing for divorce this week. I just wanted to say it does get better. I was blind to just how manipulative and controlling she was and now that I've been on my own for 5 months nothing but good things have come my way. I do still get lonely sometimes but my son keeps my mind off of things and certainly keeps me busy. It's just a good feeling knowing I don't need her, I don't think I ever did in the first place. I became codependent to a toxic person. The best thing I ever did was finally let her go. Good to hear you are doing better, buddy, good on you. If this guy doesn't have the desire to be with a pregnant woman or even want to become a family man, then their relationship is certainly doomed. And you don't want her either. Man, karma seems to be smacking back hard on her right now. That's part of what astounds me. How quickly she got pregnant with this guy. I've always been the one to drop what I've been doing to take care of our kid. I can already see their relationship crumbling after this kid is born. I put up with a lot of shit when I was with her and it really did test my resolve. I don't see this man being anywhere near as patient as I was with her. Affairs tend to be rather careless endeavors. She was willing to risk an entire marriage for a few minutes of fun, so why would using a prophylactic even be considered at that point? Good, finally karma slapped her. Don't forgive her. And don't involve this type of person again in your life in future. One more, she's completely changed and already tastes affairs. Don't believe her. get divorce. In the future definitely you will get best loyal life partner. That time she lost a good husband and beautiful son also. Focus on your future. All the best. That was the absolute hardest part to accept. She is no longer the person I fell in love with. She's shown me what she's capable of when things get hard. She can continue her crazy, hectic, complicated life without me, and I'm going to be just fine. The only pressure and noise I feel now is when I have to deal with her, which is rare. We hope you have enjoyed today's episode. Please comment, like and subscribe. Cheers. Have a wonderful day or night, wherever you are.